Hey everybody, hope you are doing well. We're going to do the title track from my favorite Steely Dan album, The Royal Scam. And I want you to listen closely and tell me if you can hear the grunt that comes out right in the middle of the tune. All right, so without further ado, here's The Royal Scam by Steely Dan.
Thank you.
love that long, slow fade out. Little guitar licks in the background, little keyboard licks. I mean, that song is a study in space within the song. I think that's part of the reason why the background harmony vocals stand out so, so perfectly. And then, of course, that guitar lick hard panned all the way over to the left-hand side. Just magical. The horns bopping back and forth, those muted horns bopping back and forth from the left speaker to the right speaker, depending upon what fills they're doing at that particular point. And yes, there is a grunt right about here. It's just again, perfect timing, perfect placement. Don't even know if it was originally meant to be there. I mean, maybe the mic was left up on, you know, on his vocals, and it just happened to be a thing that came through, and they were like, you know what? That really actually works. I mean, I almost can't imagine somebody writing a lyric sheet out and saying, okay, now grunt, you know, grunt at 3 minutes and 20 seconds into the song. But who knows? Maybe it's just dumb luck. Maybe it's a happy accident. Maybe it was intended. I mean, I've been saying it for years, and I will defend it to the end of time. Without the Royal Scam, Steely Dan doesn't make the album Asia, which I know there are quite a few people out there who consider Asia to be one of the perfect recorded albums. And again, you know, without the Royal Scam, I don't think that Steely Dan can make Asia, because Asia, as perfectly as it's recorded, and it's a wonderful album, but the Royal Scam has actual songs on it that are very easy to follow, very easy to hook into, and yet they're complex and complicated and intriguing and interesting. And so I think, you know, the Royal Scam is crucial to Steely Dan's career. At least in my opinion. I mean, I'm biased. It's my favorite album of theirs, so whatever. Please feel free to leave a comment in the comment section below. We can talk about it further. Know that I appreciate you, and I wish you all well. Take care.